If you're watching this video, chances are you probably work for yourself or you've been thinking about it. Maybe you've been lured in by the idea of not having your own boss, getting to set your own hours, and the potential to be earning a lot more money working for yourself. But there's a lot of misconception out there as to what it's actually like to work for yourself and what that's going to mean for you as an independent contractor. So let's look at 6 things that most people do not know about being their own boss. As your own boss, you are either self-employed or you're an entrepreneur, but you're not both. Entrepreneurs have a business idea that they're looking to scale and grow. While if you're self-employed, you get to set your own hours and set your own wages, but there's no real structured plan for growth involved. Self-employment is usually either highly unorganized or not very profitable. It can become highly unorganized if you try and take on all aspects of running a business yourself. This can be tempting as a way to save money because you can do that accounting yourself. You can go ahead and do those taxes. You could do the marketing, the sales. Why not do it all instead of paying somebody else to do it? But this becomes a rather unfocused approach where you're not really specialized in any one skill set. On the other hand, it's also easy for self-employment to become unprofitable because paying people to do all of these other things can get very expensive. Sometimes they command a higher wage than the wage that you're setting for yourself, and this leads to less profitability in your business plan. In order to become profitable, you need to find and develop a highly profitable skill set for yourself. This allows you to outsource other aspects of your business to paid professionals without losing money on that. So for example, let's say you want to become a sales professional and you command $80 an hour to consult out this sales professional business. That means that you can pay someone else $40 an hour to go ahead and do your taxes. You can pay someone else $30 an hour to go do your marketing, and you can go ahead and continue to find professionals to outsource other aspects of your business, knowing that you're always going to be profitable because they are commanding a lower wage than you are. A dental practice is a good example of a private business that people set up and run, and these businesses hardly ever go under. Now, I'm not suggesting that you go ahead and apply to dental school and try and become a dentist, but in practice, it helps to look at this because a lot of people that go to dental school want to set up their own practice, and this involves running their own business. Now, these people aren't really trained in how to run their own business, but they end up succeeding a lot of the time because they command such a high wage that they're able to make mistakes. They can hire out people, maybe not even get the best price, and still be profitable going forward. You have to make time to achieve that work-life balance. You really have to work at this. It's not just going to be handed to you. A lot of times you think that being your own boss means that you have the flexibility to set your own hours and you get more time to spend on the hobbies that you enjoy. But unless you're making a significant effort to actually pursue those hobbies, they're not going to happen because you're going to get carried away in the day-to-day of running your own business, in trying to make ends meet, and in trying to keep this business organized. So you actually have to commit to working towards that work-life balance if you want it to happen. People are going to try and exploit you when you start your own business. Not everyone wants to take advantage of you, but there are a lot of these people out there. When you first start a business, you're going to get approached and offered business loans and business financing. If you register a website for your business and you don't get WHOIS protection, then your name and email address will be given out and you'll be spammed with different online opportunities for your business almost weekly. There are so many different ways that people are going to try and offer you things that may not be valuable. So it really helps to have a fundamental decision-making process for your business and for vetting opportunities that come your way. If you're able to set a high-paying wage right from the beginning of structuring your own personal business, then all of a sudden you have a fundamental decision-making process going forward. If something approaches you as an opportunity for your business and it adds value to that business, while the request is a lower cost than your hourly wage, then you can go ahead and move forward with that. So hiring out an accountant to do your accounting makes sense. If they're only charging you $30 an hour, but you're commanding $80 an hour, why focus your time on that when you can get a higher wage elsewhere? Setting up an LLC also makes sense if you can find someone for under $80 an hour to do that. You know that an LLC is helpful because it's an industry standard for having your own business. So doing that at a lower cost than your personal wage always makes sense going forward. If you don't have this structure, then you have no real way to fall back on and no way to make decisions when something approaches you. So you might say to yourself, hey, everyone's taking advantage of me. I'm gonna do everything myself. That's not gonna be healthy. That's gonna lead to a lot of stress. Or you might say, hey, I just wanna take this opportunity because it seems good with no real reason for that. And that can lead you to take a lot of opportunities that aren't going to be beneficial for your business in the long run. You may fail a bunch of times before you ever become successful. Successful people aren't just good at everything. They can't just hop into any business and be great at it. They found the right business in the right niche that commands a high income, and they are able to scale and grow that and become successful. Maybe they tried a lot of times in order to get there. Maybe they got lucky and just found the right niche, or maybe they went to school for something and decided they wanted to start their own business in that, knowing that it was a high income field. Either way, these people aren't necessarily great at everything. And as an entrepreneur, you might fail quite a few times before you find that right niche and that right idea. It's part of life, and it's not something to get upset about or down about. Kind of removing your ego and your pride with failure is the best approach to have, because failure is always a learning opportunity. It's not something you should take personally, because at the end of the day, businesses and having success as an entrepreneur are largely about timing and being in the right place at the right time. So there's only so much you can do to control the outcome of any given business venture that you hop into. Are you an independent contractor, or are you self-employed? Let me know what your experience has been like, what issues you've had, what kind of struggles you've had, and if this lifestyle, if this type of employment has suited you well, and what your goals are for it going forward.